Hi, I'm Dr. Krishna Patil. I'm a consultant nephrologist at Sunshine Hospitals in Gachibowli, Hyderabad. Today I am here to discuss about an important procedure that all nephrologists perform, that is the kidney biopsy. It's a very important test to come to some conclusion about many kidney related diseases. So, what are the common indications in which we do this biopsy? There are certain kidney diseases called nephrotic syndrome in which there is huge amount of protein leaking into the urine. They can be due to different forms of diseases related to the kidney's filters, and these patterns can be recognized on a kidney biopsy. So nephrotic syndrome is one indication. In a diabetic patient, if the kidney function starts to deteriorate rapidly and if we are suspecting a non-diabetic entity in a diabetic patient, then we can do kidney biopsy to rule out any other causes in a diabetic kidney disease. If there is a rapid progressing kidney failure, this can be due to acute glomerulonephritis, that is inflamed kidneys filters. So again here we do a kidney biopsy to find the cause. If there is kidney failure which is slowly progressing but of undetermined cause, we don't know the cause. To find out cause, we can do a kidney biopsy. Sometimes we also do kidney biopsy to assess whether the kidney function is the kidney disease is reversible or it has become irreversible. In certain diseases like lupus nephritis, we may do to understand the severity of the kidney disease or to find the class. That is, there are different classes of lupus nephritis, class 1 to class 6. To assess the class, we may do a kidney biopsy. In a kidney transplant patient, if the creatinine starts to rise, commonest reason is rejection or toxicity of drugs or certain infections. To find out what is the exact cause, we may have to do a kidney biopsy. So these are some common indications in which we do a kidney biopsy. What is the procedure? The patient has to lie down prone, that is on his abdomen, like seen in this picture. Since the patient has to lie down prone, we ask the patient generally to avoid taking heavy meal before the procedure. There is no stringent requirement of being fasting overnight, but it's better that the patient has eaten something very light or is fasting. The procedure is done under local anesthesia. There is no requirement of spinal or general anesthesia. The performer himself will inject a local anesthetic agent from the skin up to the kidney's capsule after cleaning the site where the biopsy is to be performed. And under ultrasound guidance with an automated biopsy gun, the kidney is pierced and 2 to 3 samples are obtained. Generally, the procedure lasts for a few minutes. The common risks that are related to biopsy: there is 1 in 10 chance of having reddish tinge of urine due to blood in urine. Generally, it clears within 1 to 2 days. 1 in 100, there is a chance of frank blood in urine causing drop in hemoglobin level, which mandates blood transfusion. There is 1 in 1,000 chance of needing renal angiogram to localize the bleeding vessel and embolize to stop the bleeding. And 1 in 2,000, there can be a chance of bleeding not resolving despite embolization, for which a surgical removal of that kidney might be needed. Now, it is important to note that these statistics have been obtained over last few decades of biopsies performed all over the world. And in last few decades, the procedure has been made more and more safe with newer and newer techniques, especially automated guns and easy accessibility for ultrasound guidance. Hence, the risk is minimal, but since we are pricking an organ which is inside percutaneously, there could be a chance. So to minimize this risk of bleeding, what precautions do we take? We generally ask the patient if he is taking any blood thinners like aspirin, clopidogrel, ticagrelor, or heparin injections. If the patient is on any of such blood thinners, then they are asked to stop these medicines for at least 1 week prior to biopsy. The platelet count should be above 1.5 lakh or at least above 1 lakh. And there is a test called INR, prothrombin time, which should be below 1.5. So these will ensure that the chance of bleeding is minimal. Now, precautions after doing kidney biopsy. Generally, after kidney biopsy, we ask the patient to remain in a supine, that is on his back, sleep on his back straight for at least 24 hours. A strict bed rest for 24 hours is ideal to avoid any bleeding risk. The patient is allowed to eat and drink normally, and we ask the patient to be observant of the blood in urine for next 24 hours. We send a hemoglobin level after 8 hours of biopsy to see if there has been any drop due to significant bleed. And after 24 hours of observation, generally the patient is discharged and can continue his normal day-to-day activities, but we ask them to avoid strenuous physical activity, heavy exercise, or very long distance travels for at least 1 week after the biopsy. When to expect the results? When a kidney biopsy is performed, it is sent to a kidney pathologist for three types of tests. They are light microscopy, immunofluorescence microscopy, and if required, electron microscopy. The light microscopy and immunofluorescence microscopy, which we generally ask, the report is available in 3 to 4 working days. Whereas if electron microscopy is required, the charges are different and the results may take 2 to 3 weeks to come. Thank you.